Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am coming at you with another What I Eat in a Day video, and I will be sure to add all of the ingredients for each one of the recipes down in the description box below this video. And I am so glad that you landed on my channel. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Chelsea Knutson. I'm a certified holistic health coach, and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female-related conditions using food as medicine. Be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you never miss an episode. So let's get started. I am going to start with making my first juice of the day. And this is going to be just a plain celery juice. I have started to absolutely love celery juice. It is so hydrating and so healing and so alkalinizing for the body. If you are struggling with any type of female-related issues, adding plain celery juice is going to help tremendously. And the other thing that it does is it helps with cravings. So if you're having cravings for all kinds of different foods, then celery juice is an excellent addition to your diet. So I'm just slicing off the ends of this celery, and then I'm going to rinse it, and then I'm going to run it through my juicer. Then I remembered I have to slice the celery up into small pieces because I have to use my old juicer, and my old juicer does not do well with celery. I dropped my green star on the floor where my husband dropped it and broke it, and we had to send it into the company in order to get it repaired. So I'm having to slice the celery into small pieces so that it doesn't jam up my old juicer. It's the only thing that my old juicer does not do well is celery, and that is the champion juicer. So I'm slicing this, and as once I get it sliced, I'm going to run these vegetables through the juicer. Also, if you're interested in this knife, I will put a link down in the description box so you can get it. I absolutely love this knife. It cuts very well, and when you're on this lifestyle, you have to make sure you have good kitchen tools, or it makes things take longer and it frustrates you. So here's my good old trusty champion juicer. I'm putting the celery through the juicer, and I'm just going to get all that juice out. Two heads of celery makes about a liter of juice, and for me that costs $4. One tip that I have for you is that when you are trying to find containers to store your juice, use glass. And what I typically do is the old juice containers from the good quality juices, I save them, and that's what I use for my juices, or I'll use mason jars. Those are the two that I use, but I actually like these better. Now it's time for some tea. Today I'm gonna have some hibiscus tea. I love hibiscus tea. It's very flavorful. It has a trillion health benefits to it, but one of the main ones is that it lowers cholesterol, it helps with weight loss, it helps lower blood pressure, it helps with female reproductive issues. And look at my fancy cup, y'all. I absolutely love this cup, and the reason I love it is because I like to buy my teas in bulk. And if you want this hibiscus tea, I will leave it down in the description box so you can purchase this one that I buy all the time. But it saves money to buy tea in bulk. So this cup, what it does is you just have a big cup. It holds almost 2 cups of water, and it has a little insert where you put your tea leaves. You put the tea leaves in there, and then you pour your water into your cup, and then it has this little lid that you put on top, and you let your tea steep for a while, you know, 5, 10, 15 minutes, however long you like your tea to steep, and then you remove the lid, and then you remove the insert, and then you sit the insert inside the lid to catch any additional water that might be dripping out. And then you can drink your tea at your leisure. So now it's time to make some more juice. This is one of my favorite juice recipes for female reproductive health. It is so healing. Beet, apple, lemon. Beet, apple, lemon. So one beet. I usually like to use a larger beet than this, but this is all they had at the store. So I like to buy really large beets and then four large apples. And then the biggest lemon you can find. You can even put more than one lemon in the juice. But what happens is this combination, you will literally feel it in your body doing work. You will, like, there have been times when I've drank this juice and I could just feel it go straight to my reproductive system to heal. I think that there is something magical about this juice. So I try to drink it as often as possible. One of the things that makes it taste really good is just adding the lemon, because it tones down the taste of the beet if you don't really like beet. And also the apples help with digestion, and it helps with moving sludge out of your body. And sludge is just toxic waste out of your body. But this is a fabulous juice for all reproductive issues. I have gotten lots of healing in my body from using this particular juice, and I hope that you will try it. So look at this juice. It is so nice and rich and red and flavorful. Oh my goodness, it's so good. And just that recipe, that beet, the four apples and the lemon actually made 1 liter of juice. So that's pretty cheap. That was like maybe $2 or $3, depending on how cheap you got your apples. Because beets, they don't weigh very much. They don't cost very much. So don't tell me that you cannot juice cheaply, because you can. It really just depends on what you're juicing. And if you think about all the other things that you buy, like the junky foods that you buy, and you stop buying that stuff and you actually put your money into the healthy foods and plan well, it won't be more expensive. If you just go to the store randomly and just shop and just throw things in your cart without a plan, then yeah, you're gonna spend too much money. So guess what this is? It's actually a melon, and it looks like honeydew melon, but it is not. This is called a cassava melon, and I cut this up the other day and it was a lot of fruit, so we couldn't finish it all. So I am just having some for lunch. I'm having a big bowl of it. Actually, I'm ending up putting this whole bowl in there. I should have just taken the saran wrap off of the bowl and just eaten it from this bowl, because really I just ended up eating this whole thing. So it was really good. This is probably really a snack portion. I have had more in my refrigerator. I probably could have eaten more, but this was satisfying. I would say if you can get your hands on a cassava melon this summer, it is worth it. So it sort of tastes like honeydew, watermelon, and cantaloupe mixed together. That's what it tastes like. So if you are interested, you can find them at pretty much any natural food store, maybe even like Asian markets or Mexican markets, things like that may carry them. I'm not sure, but I saw it at Whole Foods and it was $5 for this great big melon. So I grabbed a hold of it and I absolutely loved it for this meal. Okay, so y'all see what I'm doing. It's time for my big, big salad that I'm making. And just remember, all of the ingredients that I'm using are gonna be down in the description box so that you can replicate this recipe and make it your own. So the first thing I'm doing is I'm ripping the leaves off of this head of green leaf lettuce, and I'm sticking it in my salad spinner. You guys can look down in the description box for the salad spinners that I recommend in my Amazon store if you're interested. But you can use whatever kind of lettuce you want. I just happen to like green leaf lettuce. I like romaine lettuce, and I like soft butter lettuce. Those are my favorite lettuces. And so the other thing to remember is that when you are making salads for the first time, you're probably not gonna like them. But look at salad like it's medicine, and keep on eating them. Eat them every day. Eat a salad every day. Eat a salad, or every other day, eat a salad, whatever you've got to do. And eventually you will start to crave the salads. And don't put a whole bunch of nasty salad dressing from the grocery store on your salads. I'm going to show you how to make a nice salad dressing that is low fat and good for healing in this particular video. So like I said, all the ingredients are down in the description box below. But let's get that salad rinsed off and let's get it in the bowl. I am making this salad for two people, me and Kenny. And this is one head of lettuce, and this head of lettuce cost me $1.50. And I'm gonna start with a nice ripe tomato. I'm gonna cut it in half and then chop it into chunks, smaller chunks, not tiny chunks, but smaller chunks. But you can do whatever you want. You can do wedges, you can do whatever you want with your tomato. Just make sure that when you are cutting tomatoes, you have a nice sharp knife, because if you don't, it's going to be difficult to cut the tomatoes. I am using my serrated knife that comes with the set of the chef knife, and this is one of the knives that comes with it. So again, the link is down in the description box if you would like to check this knife out. I got it on Amazon. I got the butcher block and a few of the knives and some kitchen shears with it, and I'm absolutely loving it. Next, I'm going to add some carrots. These are pre-shredded carrots that I got from the grocery store. Love them. I don't have to mess with cutting them or shredding them, but I don't have a problem doing that either, because it only takes a few seconds to do that, about a minute to cut up carrots. Blueberries. I love blueberries in my salad. Look at the color of those blueberries though. Like, they are absolutely amazing for your health. Like, they're full of antioxidants and they build your immune system. So if you're concerned about your immunity this year with the COVID and everything going on, pile blueberries in your salad every day when you make it, or some kind of berry. So I had a little bit of leftover avocado that I needed to get rid of. So this is a half of an avocado that I'm going to add to the salad. Also, if you see a little bit of brown on your avocado, don't worry about it. Just scrape it off and use it. If it's really brown and hard, then you probably need to get rid of that avocado. But this little bit doesn't bother me. Next, we have some red cabbage. Love red cabbage in my salad because it adds some crunch, and it's a cruciferous vegetable and it helps move excess estrogen out of the body. So this is one of the reasons why I use cabbage sometimes in my salads. Then I've got some red onion. Red onion is really good raw in your salad. So many nutrients in red onions. Onions in general, but I particularly prefer the color in the red onions. So try to get red onions in your food every day if you're making a salad. Plus, there's lots of flavor that comes along with red onions as well. I like to chop mine up finely because whenever they're too chunky, they can be overpowering in the salad. So I like to cut them up small so I can distribute them all over the salad. Same thing with the red cabbage. I like to cut it up small so I can distribute it throughout the salad so I don't get these big hunking pieces throughout the salad. I like to distribute the flavors all throughout. And then once we've got that all chopped up, we just add it to the salad. I wish I could have done this in real time. It really doesn't take that long to make these salads. And if you've been watching my YouTube channel for any length of time, you will have seen me make salads in real time, and you will find that it doesn't take very long to make salads. It takes less time to make salads than sometimes putting together a whole standard American dinner, a standard American diet dinner each day. So don't use that as an excuse. And as you practice your cutting skills, you will get faster and faster. And that's one of the reasons why it is such a good idea to have a good knife. Next, I'm gonna add some cucumbers. Small amount, I'm just gonna sprinkle them on top. I'm gonna chop them small, put them on the salad to add some additional crunch. And last but not least, I'm gonna show you how to make this Asian hemp seed dressing that is so easy and so tasty. It's low in fat, but it packs a big flavor punch. Now I'm adding some hemp seeds, 2 tablespoons of hemp seeds, then 2 tablespoons of coconut aminos. Then I've got 2 tablespoons of water. Then you eyeball it with your garlic. I put probably about 1/2 teaspoon of garlic. I really like garlic. I'm a garlic lover, so that's what I would put in there. You could even put more in there, or you could leave it out completely. You put onion powder in instead if you wanted to. And then I've got some red pepper flakes, and really you need a little bit of spice, but if you don't like spicy foods, leave it out. I could have put more than this in, but the key with dressings is you want to tantalize all the taste in the flavor, the sour, the sweet, the salty, and the savory. And then I've got 1 tablespoon of raw honey. You can use dates in here. So I'm using my TriBest personal blender. I love this blender. I've had it for at least 10, 11 years, and I use it all the time for my salad dressings. It is a great investment. TriBest is an excellent company. It's the same company that makes the Green Star juicer. So you blend it and blend it and blend it until it is absolutely smooth. It's got a perfect consistency. It is not too thick, not too thin. And this is what I'm gonna have on my salad, and it tastes great. I didn't have to add any other seasonings. So as you all know, I work from home, so I can make this stuff and put it in my refrigerator for my work day. But if I worked outside of the home, I would take all of these things and I would put them in my lunch bag and I would take them to work with me. So if you work outside of the home, do that for yourself. It will benefit you greatly. But I would love to know what you think of this video, what kinds of recipes you would like to see going forward. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, comment below, and thank you so much for watching. And until next time, y'all, take care.